Hello students, I welcome you all to the e-learning sessions of Automobile Engineering. Myself Hardik Shah, and during this lecture we will discuss some interesting topic in the subject of automotive electricals and electronics. Fine, we have already started a new chapter on the batteries and starting systems, right? And our today's topic in this video is lead acid battery, its construction and working. Okay, I hope you will see this video till the end to completely understand this topic and gain your skills in automobile engineering. Fine, I request you all to note down the queries during the lecture and ask in comment section. Okay, I will try to solve all the queries as soon as possible. So now let's start our today's video. So what is a lead acid battery? So let's see first definition, and thereafter I will explain you in detail. So definition is, the battery which uses sponge lead and the lead peroxide for the conversion of the chemical energy into electrical energy, such type of battery is called lead acid battery. Done. So the lead acid battery is most commonly used in the power stations and the substations because it has the higher cell voltages and the cost is very much low compared to other batteries. Fine. So now let's see the construction of the lead acid battery. The various parts of the lead acid battery are shown in this figure. So the container and the plates are the main part of the lead acid battery. The container stores the chemical energy which is converted into electrical energy by the help of the plates. Okay, so let's understand this in detail. So first is container. So the container of the lead acid battery is made of the glass, you can, or lead lined wood, ebonite, the hard rubber of the bituminous compound, ceramic materials or molded plastics, and they are seated in a top to avoid the discharge of the electrolyte. Okay, at the bottom of the container there are four ribs. On two of them rests the positive plate and on other supports the negative plates. Okay, the prism serves as the support for the plates and at the same time it protects them from the short circuiting with the negative and positive plates. Okay, the material of which the battery containers are made should be resistant to the sulfuric acid. It should not deform or porous or contain impurities which actually damages the electrolyte. So these are the container types. Okay, second is plate. The plate of the lead acid cell is a diverse design and they are consist of some form of grid which is made up of the lead and the active materials. Okay, the grid is essential for conducting the electric current and for distributing the current equally on the active materials. If the current is not uniformly distributed, the active material will loosen and it will fall out. Okay, the plates of the lead acid battery is actually shown in figure here. So the grids are made up of the alloy of lead and the antimony. Okay, these are usually made with the transverse rib that crosses the places at the right angle, or you can say diagonally. Okay, the grid for the positive and negative plates are of the same design, but the grid for the negative plates are made up of the lighter because they are not as essential for the uniform conduction of the current. Okay, the plates of the battery are actually of the two types. Okay, they are, first is plant plates and second is pasted plates. Plant and pasted. Okay, in plant plates actually they are used largely for the stationary batteries as these are very heavier in weight and more costly than the pasted plates. Okay, but the plates are more durable and less liable to lose active material by rapid charging and discharging. Okay, the plant plate have low capacity weight ratio. Okay, pasted process is much suitable for the manufacturing of the negative plates rather than positive plates. Okay, the negative active material is quite tough and it undergoes a comparatively low change from the charging and discharging. That was about the pasted plates. Okay, next is active material. So what is that? The material in a cell which takes active participation in chemical reactions like absorption or evolution of the electric energy, okay, during the charging or discharging is called as a active material of this cell, okay. The active elements of the lead acid batteries are lead peroxide, that is PbO2. It forms the positive active material. The PbO2 are dark chocolate broom in a color, okay, it is like chocolate color. Sponge lead, it's formed the negative active material, it is in a gray color, okay. Now dilute sulfuric acid, that is H2SO4, it is used as an electrolyte. It contains 31% of the sulfuric acid. The lead peroxide and the sponge lead, which forms the negative and positive active materials, have the little mechanical strength, okay, and therefore they can be used alone or you can say separately, okay. Next is separators. So what is that? The separators are the thin sheets of the non-conducting materials made up of chemically treated lead wood, porous rubbers or mats of the glass fibers, and they are placed between the positive and the negative to insulate them from each other, so they don't connect with each other, okay. Separators are grooved vertically on one side and they are smooth on the other side. So that was the construction type. Next is battery terminals. A battery has two terminals. First is positive, second is negative, okay. The positive terminal with a diameter of 17.5 mm at the top is slightly larger than the negative terminal. This is actually 16 mm in diameter. So positive is larger, negative is smaller, okay. So this was all about the main construction part of the battery, that is lead acid battery. Now let's move to the principle of the lead acid battery, that how it is actually working. So in lead acid battery, when the sulfuric acid dissolves, its molecules break up into positive hydrogen ions like 2H+ and the sulfate negative ions like SO4-, okay, and moves very freely. If the two electrodes are immersed in a solution and connected to DC supply, then the hydrogen ions being positively charged and move towards the electrodes and connected to the negative terminal of the supply. Done. So the SO4, that is SO4- ions, being negatively charged, so they are moving towards the electrodes connected to positive terminal. So H will go to negative, SO4 will go to the positive side, okay, that is the anode side. Now each hydrogen ions takes one electron from the cathode and each sulfate ions take the two negative ions from the anode, and it reacts with the water and forms the sulfuric and hydrogen acid. Done. So this oxygen react with the lead oxide and forms the lead peroxide, that is PbO2. Thus during the charging, the lead cathode remains as a lead, but a lead anode gets converted into lead peroxide, that is chocolate in color. So if the DC source of supply is disconnected and if the voltmeter is connected between the electrodes, it will show the potential difference between both of them. Done. So if wire connects the electrodes, then the current will flow from the positive plate to the negative plate, okay, through this external circuit, that is the cell is capable of supplying the electrical energy. Done. So what is that? When the cell is fully discharged, the anode is of the lead peroxide, PbO2, and the cathode is of the sponge lead, that is Pb, okay. When the electrodes are connected through the resistance, the cell discharges and electron flow in the direction opposite to that of the charging, okay. So the hydrogen ions move to the anode and reaching the anode receives one electron from the anode and become the hydrogen atom, okay. The hydrogen atom comes in a contact with the PbO2, so it attacks and forms the lead sulfate, that is PbSO4, that is whitish in color and water according to chemical equations. It is shown here also, okay. So the each sulfate ion, that is SO4-, moves towards the cathode and reaching there gives up two electrons, that becomes SO4, and attacks the metallic lead cathode and forms the lead sulfate, which is also whitish in a color according to this chemical reaction, okay. So this was about the main working part. Now let's see what is happening during the recharging. So for recharging, the anode and cathodes are connected to the positive and negative terminals of the DC supply mains. Done. The molecules of the sulfuric acid break up into the ions of the 2H plus plus SO4 minus. The hydrogen ions being positively charged move towards the cathodes and receives 2 electrons from there and form a hydrogen atom. Done. The hydrogen atom reacts with the lead sulfate cathode forming lead and sulfuric acid according to the chemical equation. Done. So SO4 minus ion will move towards the anode. It gives up the 2 additional electrode and become the radical and react with the lead sulfate anode that forms the lead peroxide and lead sulfuric acid according to the different chemical reaction. So this was all about the recharging of the battery, of the lead acid battery. Now the charging and discharging are represented by the single reversible equation like this, and this equation should be read downwards for discharging and upward for the recharge. So this is the main equation that we are actually using for charging and discharging. So that's it in today's session. In next session we will discuss more about the different types of batteries in details. Okay, so I hope you like this video. Please comment on the video if you have any query, and thanks for watching. Stay tuned, keep learning.